jam over on the boards. Quintal and King. King and Quintal.
King is throwing punches, but he isn't reaching Quintal. Stefan got a couple good lefts in there. Austin Ballas throwing a punch. Gotta give the decision to Quintal, though.
To him all night long. And he seemed to have something, Derek, to say to the Bruin bench on his way to the penalty box.
What he did there is a shove by Quintal. Now they're going to start to get the sticks up. Now they're going to fight. Okay, let's get at it. Now Quintal in the wrestling match. He's going to jockey for position. He's got to get his arm free. Stefan goes under the body. There's right over the top.
McGill.
Boy, he got Duras' sweater off, but I didn't know Peter Duras could fight like that.
We haven't seen him. He went with Sutter. With the score, Chicago 1, Boston nothing. Chicago City.
I got to give it to Lyndon.
Thank you. About time, Fred. Lyndon Byers, all he did was tackle him around the knees. Byers can fight. And he can play. Unfortunately, he gets there. He had a great opportunity. He's had a nice game. He's had some chances today once. Stellar opportunity that was robbed by Cloutier.
Now we've got a battle going. Here's Alan May and Hartman. Hartman might pick up the instigator on this fight. May stood back for a little while and then finally started throwing them. Hartman threw a haymaker miss. It almost fell in his face. Alan May has 291 minutes in penalty. Neither one of them are angels. And Hartman with 196 minutes in penalty. You know, I was just going to say, Buffalo are starting to pick it up a little bit physically here in the second period. More hits.
Puck, that was time, just a minute. What do we got going here? Mermsen and Gord Donley
hit by Merzen on Donnelly in the corner, and then Donnelly dropped the gloves immediately. He's no stranger to the penalty box to that part of the game. He went with Dina Merzen. Difficulty pulling them apart. Sean Cronin was picked first star in the game Friday night by one of the Winnipeg radio broadcasters. And here he shows Hunter and Cronin lined up together at the faceoff. Here they give each other a shove. Off come the gloves pretty quickly. They look at each other and away they go. And they only get roughing penalties because it was just more or less a wrestling match. Cronin finally gets on top. No punches thrown.
John Cullen. Cullen put it in front. There's Bork, and he kicked at it, and he put it right on the net, and McLean will stop it. Now Butcher and Bork get involved, and Butcher with a right hand. Bork trying to get himself free. Butcher fighting like a wild man. And Bork throwing that right hand, too. They're really going to it. Garth Butcher and Phil Bork. And Bork, Butcher's getting some uppercuts on Borky now. And Bork's coming back with that right hand. Still standing tall is Phil Bork. Butcher's now in a little trouble, and they got to get out of the way and let Bork have an opportunity to get back here. The linesman will do that.
I think Borky got a lot of right hands in on Butcher. Butcher's more accustomed to this stuff than Bork is. But Bork did a heck of a job against a pretty tough customer, Garth Butcher, and he's smiling. Nice job, Borky.
Pride in the carryover tomorrow because, you know, it's so competitive in the National Hockey League. If you don't do that night after night, boy, you can just get away from you.
Still loose in their zone. Miller gets hooked and turned around. No penalty call. Now the gloves are off, and they've got some activity. Crowder wailing away for the Kings against Cullen of the Penguins. He's finally drawn into a battle he tried to avoid all day, but he's acquitting himself pretty well. Down they go, the linesmen to intervene.
It's sort of a mismatch in terms of physical strength there. Crowder a lot bigger than Johnny Cullen.
Although Cullen, they say, held up his end very, very well with a score of the Kings 8, the Penguins 1. Let's pause for a regional break.
Here's what's happening in front of Montreal's goalkeeper, Patrick Roy.
Mike Allison got pushed out of there quite heavily, just came back, took up some exception. Mike Allison, not a fighter by any means. He just tried to neutralize his hands.
Coach's union is going to be tough. I can see that.
We've got a scrap breaking out here as Mike Keane is throwing the punches and connecting with Keith Crowder. Now Crowder fires him back. And Keane responds with the left. I think that surprised Crowder. Crowder thrown a couple of lefts, and then Keane hits his left hand loose and does some damage. So the linesmen, Kevin Collins and Shane Heyer, go to work. And we'll have some penalties here as Montreal behind the net. Two more guys square off. Jay Miller is involved on behalf of the Kings, and Todd Ewan. I don't think Ewan has had much ice time, if any, until now. I don't really call him being out there, but two big, tough guys. Todd the enforcer, Todd the animal, Todd the artist, Todd everything. And Jay Miller.
There's a couple of heavyweights there. Jake's this interesting thing as we watch Todd have a good go out of here with Jay Miller on the receiving end. He had a couple of good right hands earlier. Interesting guy, Todd Ewan. Call him the difference. Scored a big goal against Minnesota earlier. Also an interesting guy. Would you believe that he's a pretty good piano player, bass drum player, and also can play the guitar? You wouldn't see it right there.
The Wake Up Book Review. Have you read it?
No, I couldn't. No, it's too deep for me.
I set him up, Herb knocks him down.
Yeah, well, you knew this was coming. There's no question right after this spot. And Todd, that earlier little scrap, Mike Keane.
For a forward, I think that's a great number. He leads his team by a mile.
Oh, left.
Jeff Chychrun and Neil Sheehy are going at it. But it was Drews and Craig Berube that started it, it looked like. We had a pretty good picture of a spear by John Drews on Craig Berube.
I think it may have been Tucker.
Or Tucker, rather. You're right. Not Drews, Tucker, number 12.
And a game misconduct, and that may be the case. Let's watch it again.
Top of your screen. Oh, there was the one jab by Berube.
And
there's
there
the other one right there. Berube's was a little lower than Tucker's, but they exchanged spears, no question about it.
Both of them will go to the penalty box.
Like Neil Sheehy was trying to turn